I'm Anne Emery. You're watching DataViz on the Go, the series where you learn DataViz time savers inside everyday software like Excel. And earlier today, I was leading a workshop for a group of consultants, and one of the people at their consulting firm was like, "What do you do about dense graphs?" And I've got three go-tos that I use over and over and over that come to the rescue time and time again. So let's pretend we're looking at a really busy, really dense line graph, although these techniques can be used across all the different graph types. Okay, so here's the problem. Here's the before version, the challenge that we're running into. It's obviously a lot to look at. So fix number one is you gray out everything and then you highlight one line at a time. Lots of sidekicks, but you only get one main character. So in this case, you might highlight the average. That's what people would see first. And then a split second later, they could look at group A and B and C and D. Fix number two is small multiples. Multiple small charts, all arranged on the screen with the same height and width and proportions and typically the same scales so that you can make accurate comparisons across different graphs. In this case, you might leave the average line on each of the graphs and then just show line A on A's graph and line B on B's graph and so on. Fix number three is movement. You can create movement in a few different ways. So you might set up a dynamic dashboard or a dynamic website where people can filter through and interact with the data themselves. You could also set up movement through a GIF, a looping image that you would lay out first, frame by frame by frame, and then GIF them all together. GIFs are going to be really good for social media images. They can be embedded on your website. They're going to be a lot more interesting than just a static image. The movement obviously is going to capture attention and help all the data feel like not so much data. It's going to help it feel like less. And then a third way to use movement is through really good presentation skills. So imagine you're giving a talk in person, or maybe you're giving a talk over Zoom, and you would click through with your little clicker and you would just talk about this thing. And then you'd click and you'd just talk about the next thing. And you'd click and talk about the next thing and the next thing and the next thing. You'd have to lay this out in advance, kind of frame by frame or slide by slide, and then obviously plan out what you're going to say in advance, which I know you're doing anyway. You're probably thinking like, when I get to this slide, what am I going to say? And you just make sure that the visuals match your speaking points and it's nice and cohesive. Okay, so here's a recap of the before and the three fixes. We've got fix number one, the gray. Fix number two, small multiples. Fix number three, movement. Either by interactivity or by a looping GIF or by a really dynamic presentation where you're clicking through one slide at a time, matching your speaking points to the visuals that people are looking at. If you've got how-to questions about any of these, comment down below. I'll help you out. If you've got questions about how these techniques might apply to other graph types, comment down below. I'll help you out.